find out the we will try to find out the isolated points and lines and edges within the image. And later we are discussing about one more technique called so the these two topics we have already discussed. So one is your discontinuity based segmentation and another is your similarity based segmentation. So in case of this discontinuity based segmentation, we have discussed about this detecting these isolated points, lines and edges within the image. And we have one more concept related to this image segmentation based on the similarity. So that is nothing but here we are having this predefined criteria. 1 minute. Yeah, so we have this based on the similar. So I think someone has to mute. Ma'am, Ujwala ma'am, please. Yeah, thank you. Right. So we have discussed about this in the previous class. We have discussed about this discontinuity based segmentation, in which we will try to find give more importance to the image which is having this intensity value. There is what is the edge is nothing but there is a sharper sudden intensity changes values will be there. So based on that only we will try to find out the edges. And in that we discussed about detecting these isolated points, lines, line detection and edges detection. And we have discussed various algorithms which are used to detect the edges. And in the same manner, we have one more approach to do this image segmentation based on the similarity approach. If you discuss about the similarity approach, here we will try to partition the image based on the regions which are having the some predefined criteria. Like if whichever the pixels that are having the same intensity values, we will group those pixels. Or which are having same color, we will try to group those. So based on this similarity principle, we will try to segment the image. So those kind of things will come under this category, that is similarity based segmentation. In that similarity based segmentation, we have three important topics. One is the thresholding. We have three techniques, that is thresholding and region growing and region splitting and merging. But in our syllabus, we are having this thresholding only. So we will discuss about this principle of thresholding. So if you go for this principle of thresholding. Yeah, so this is your so we have discussed about all these topics. The last topic is principle of thresholding, which comes under this similarity based approach, which is used to segment the images. So in case of this similarity based approach, so what is this thresholding? So in the previous class also, I used to tell always I will divide the images based on the threshold value. Like if that whatever the intensity values of that particular image, I will compare with the threshold value. If it is greater than that particular threshold value, then I can say that image will be coming under the edges, that point will comes under edges, and otherwise it will not come under edges. But how to find out this thresholding will comes under this this one. So what is this thresholding? So thresholding is nothing but it is an important technique for image segmentation. It produces uniform regions based on the threshold criteria. We will try to find out the threshold criteria. So which based on the threshold criteria only, I will try to divide the image into different regions. So key parameter for the thresholding process is the choice of threshold value. So what is the principle of thresholding is to find out the threshold value. So if the thresholding operation is depending upon only the grayscale value, there are three types of thresholdings. One is your global thresholding, another is local thresholding, one more thing is dynamic or adaptive thresholding. So what is this global thresholding? So if the thresholding operation depends only upon the grayscale values, like what are the intensity values are there, if it is depending upon those intensity values which are between 0 to 255, then I can say it is a global thresholding value. And in case of this neighborhood properties or some local properties also taken into account, then that is called local thresholding. Like what are the local properties, like texture and what is the color and what is based on different local properties. If you, apart from the grayscale intensity values, if you are considering the local properties like color, texture, those kind of properties also if you consider, and based on that only I will do this segmentation, then I can this process comes under this local thresholding. And in case of this T depends on pixel coordinates also. What is this pixel coordinate? So if I take one image, this if I represent that image in the XY coordinates form, then I will have this is the coordinate of that particular, and what is the intensity value? This is XY coordinate. So this entire image will be having XY coordinate. So this is the xy this is the xy coordinate of that particular image, and what is the intensity of this one. So that's why I will try to represent any image in this form. So what is this f of xy? So the entire image is having these coordinate values, and what is the value in that particular coordinate is nothing but the intensity value. That may be in the grayscale range, or it may if it is a binary image, I will consider only 0 to 1 values only. If it is a grayscale image, I will try to take 0 to 255 values. So if I consider that pixel coordinates also, then I can say it is a dynamic or adaptive thresholding. So these are the three types of thresholding, in which if the thresholding operation depends only on the grayscale values or intensity values, then I can say it is a global thresholding, or it is a simple global thresholding. And if it is depending, not only depending upon the grayscale values, but also neighborhood properties, like what is the color or texture, then local properties of that particular image also, if I consider, then that is called local thresholding. And if that particular thresholding value depends upon the pixel coordinates also, then I can say it is a dynamic or adaptive thresholding. So thresholding is a function of these three things: spatial coordinates, that is x comma y. If that thresholding depending upon these xy coordinates, then I can say it is adaptive thresholding. And if it is depending upon the gray level value, what is the value of that particular pixel? So pixel at that particular coordinate, it may have some intensity value, that is the gray level intensity value. If it is depending upon that, then I can say it is a global thresholding. This is global thresholding, and this is your dynamic thresholding. And if it is depending upon the local properties of the image, that may be anything, that may be color, that may be texture, or any other thing, if I consider, then I can say it is a local thresholding. So I can say thresholding operation is expressed as, it is xy coordinates, that it may be grayscale value, it may be local properties. So this is the thresholding function. It is a function of this one. So based on this similarity principle, this segmentation can be done. In similarity principle means I will consider the pixels which are having the some predefined criteria. I will mention that particular criteria, like whoever the pixels which are having the nearby intensity values, I may take that criteria. Based on that one only, I will do segmentation. Or which are having pixel intensity difference will be, I will consider, like intensity values are there 65, something 75, 35, like that. Then I will consider the pixels which are having some difference between those pixel intensities should be some 5. Then if I define that particular criteria, then based on that only I will do segmentation. Then those kind of principles are called similarity principles. In case of the similarity principles, we will have three important techniques. One is the principle of thresholding, another is region growing, and region splitting and merging. If you want, I can give this material also, you can read out, but that is not there in our syllabus. And next one is thresholding. So in case of thresholding, we have seen, like, whenever we are considering one image, if it is a, so only I'm considering it is a one, only one image is present like this, some image is there, some image is there, then I can say I have to consider the only two parts are there in this particular image. One is your background of that particular image, and one is your foreground of that particular image. Foreground I can consider it as object, and background I can consider it as whatever the background that is having. So if I take only these two things, then I can have the technique like thresholding. In case of this one, I can divide this particular based on this. I will take the threshold value, in which if the threshold value greater than, if that particular threshold value, I will take it as 124 something or 125 something like this. All the grayscale values are 0 to 255. Then whichever is having this greater than the threshold value, then I can consider those are objects. That is nothing but that image. And whichever is having less than or equal to that threshold value, that those I will consider as background. So this is a simple global thresholding. So in case of this one, if that image is containing two or more objects, it is like having like one car is there, one car image is there, and after this one cat image is there, something like this, then I can take, I will take two threshold values, actually three. I have to consider it as three. One is like I have to take two threshold values. If it is between this t1 and t2, then I can consider it as an object B, like it is for car. And if it is greater than that particular threshold, I can consider it as another object, like it may be for cat. And whichever is having less than or equal to that particular T1 threshold, I can consider it as background. So like this, I have to use this thresholding concept, which is used to segment the images based on, if I take any image, based on that particular image, if it is having only single image, and only one background is there, then I can take only single threshold value is enough. But if you are having more number of objects, based on that one, we have this multiple threshold. So what is this types of thresholding? We have discussed there. So that is nothing but if this thresholding is a function of this coordinate point, so global thresholding means it is depending upon only the grayscale values. Local thresholding means it not only depends upon grayscale values, it also depends upon some local properties. And adaptive thresholding, it not only depends upon grayscale values, local properties, and also it is depending upon the coordinate values. So this is nothing but xy. So if it is xy, if it is depending upon xy, then I can say it is adaptive thresholding. If it is depending upon grayscale values, I can say it is a global thresholding. If it is depending upon the local properties like color, texture, then I can say it is a local thresholding. So histogram and thresholding. So always in case of this thresholding, I will try to, there is a relationship between this histogram and thresholding, in which first I will try to find out the histogram of the particular image. I think if you know about this histogram, so what is that one is nothing but, so if there is any image, if if I represent that particular image in the matrix form, then everything will be having, if it is a 500 cross 500 image, then we have 500 rows and 500 columns. Each image will have some intensity values like 255 and it may have 124 like this. Then I will take those values, like if this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, like this I will take up to 255. And how many 0 pixels are there? So that will form one, how many zero, something here I will take like this, here also 1, 2, 3, 4 like this. Then if it is considered, if it has only 4 zeros, then I will, 3 zeros, then I will do this one. If how many one number of intensity values are there, 4. I mean, how many 2 intensities, something 9. How many 3 intensities, like this. After this one, I can have the graph like this. This is called histogram of that particular image. I can represent that particular image in the histogram. So after representing that particular image on the histogram, then I will try to find out this threshold value. So that is this is your histogram and thresholding, in which the quality of the thresholding algorithm always depending upon the selection of the suitable threshold. So always thresholding algorithm, if you select the good threshold value, then I can easily segment that particular image into both objects and background. So what is the tool that is used to help out this threshold value is the histogram. Like, if we can have different types of histograms, like a unimodal histogram means nothing but we are having only one particular graph. You will be, for the entire image, you will be getting like this. Then it is called unimodal histogram. And bimodal histogram means I will be getting the histogram in this manner. Like there is a intensity values will be like this and after this one. And multimodal histograms is nothing but I will have different types of valley kind of shapes, this one. So in case of this unimodal histogram, whichever having the peak value, wherever we are getting the peak value for that particular image, that will be considered as threshold value. But in case of this multimodal bimodal histogram, here I will consider wherever there is a change happened, suddenly this wherever this is called valley, in case of this valley, I will try to find out if I will try to take this as the threshold value. But if you have multimodal histogram, then we may have different types of threshold. This is called multi-threshold. Like I can have multiple threshold values in case of, we will get this multimodal histogram whenever there are multiple objects in the image, so that I have to take two or more threshold values. In case of this bimodal threshold histogram, I have only two images. One is the background and one is the foreground. So whichever are having greater than that particular threshold value, that will be coming onto the foreground of the particular object. And whichever are having less than or equal to that particular threshold value, those will be coming on the background. So like this, based on the histogram, I will try to find out the threshold value. So what is this global thresholding? Simple thresholding, which is also called as global thresholding. Global thresholding is nothing but it is always depending upon the intensity values. So in case of this one, in case of this bimodal images, histogram have two distinct peaks. So always in case of this bimodal histogram, I have two peak values. So and there is a valley between them. So valley point will be always taken this as the threshold value. And the pixels of the given image are compared with this particular threshold. In case of this global thresholding concept, if it is a bimodal image, then I will take this as the threshold value, in which I will compare those pixel values with the threshold value. The threshold value may be in between 0 to 255 only. You may be getting some value. That value, how can you consider is by using this particular, after drawing the histogram of that particular image, I will, with wherever there is a value is there, in that particular value, I will consider it as threshold value. and I will compare all the pixel values or intensity values, because it is a global thresholding. I will give more importance to the intensity value. So if that intensity value is greater than that particular threshold value, I will consider it as the object point. I will give it as 1. And otherwise, if it is less than or equal to less than t, then I can consider it as the background. So the, I will consider it as 0. So how I will do this global thresholding? I will, what is the algorithm for this global thresholding? First, select an initial estimate for the global threshold. So first, I will try to take the initial threshold value. After taking this particular threshold value, I will segment the image using that particular thread, particular t. So it will produce two groups of pixels. So G1 is one set of pixels which are having the intensity values greater than that particular threshold value. So first, I will draw the histogram of that particular image. And after this one, I will take whatever the value is there, that I will consider it as thread t, that is your initial value. And after this one, I will divide this particular image into two groups, that is nothing but which are having greater than or equal to that particular greater than t. So I can say greater than or equal to or greater than. So if I take greater than t, then I can consider less than or equal. So if it is greater than t, I will group all the pixels into that category. Like if this threshold value is 124, then whatever the pixels which are having greater than 124 values, those are coming into group 1. And I will take one more group which are having less than 124, those will be coming into the group 2. So these are the two set of groups I am getting. And after this one, computing the average intensity values m1 and m2 for the pixels in the g1 and g2. Like all the pixel values will be there. Like in this g1 group, I may have something 255, 126, all will be greater than 3. So after doing this, I will do the average intensity value. Like how to find out this average? It may be something like it may contain some 40 values, 40 pixel values. Then I will take 255 plus 124 plus like this and divided by 40. So that I will get the average intensity value, that is in the group 1, that is m1. And after this one, in the same manner, I will get the average intensity value for this m2. After calculating this m1 and m2, which are the average intensity values of the entire pixels that are there in the group 1 and group 2, now I will try to find out the new threshold value, which is nothing but t. So that is nothing but 1 by 2 m1 plus m2. Now I will get one more threshold value, that is your new threshold value. And after this one, again, I will repeat the steps 2 to 4. Again, I will repeat. Say same thing, whichever having greater than this particular new threshold value, whichever having the pixels greater than this particular threshold value, those will be in the group 1. And again, less than or equal to will be in the G2. Again, I will try to find out the M1 and M2 values. So until I will find out the difference values, which are successive iterations is smaller than the predefined parameter. Like I will try to find out the intensity values. Like for this one, I am getting 124. And second time I will get something, as it is average, I will get something 124.1. And I will get something like 123. Next, I will get 124.0, something like this. And wherever we are having, we will define some predefined parameter, which is nothing but that if the difference is less than or equal to some 0.0001, then I can consider that is the final threshold value. Like this, I will take, this is the global thresholding algorithm, in which I can take this predefined parameter is like if the two successive threshold values different should be very, very negligible, then I can take the final threshold value. That is your global thresholding algorithm. Global thresholding algorithm. If I take something like if I am taking this fingerprint image, so this entire thing is the background. Like we are having this white color, so entire thing is the background. And this is also some background. Only this particular image, whatever we are having, this is the foreground image. So if this is your noisy fingerprint, which is having some noise values. And after this one, I will try to take the histogram of that particular image. So this you will get the histogram. If I represent this particular image, I will get this histogram. All these are grayscale values, which are between 0 to 255. So 0, 255. So zeros, I am not having that much zero values. And I'm having 63 range, more number of pixels are there in the 63 range, and 127 also very less, and 191 range are very high, 191 range are very high. So after this one, so because 0 is white color and 255 is the black color, so here after farming out this particular threshold values, wherever we are having this valley kind of shape, there I will try to consider this as the initial threshold value, like 127, I may consider it as initial threshold value. And after that one, I will try to apply the global thresholding, like whichever having greater than 127, that is one G1, and which are having less than, then I will consider G2. And after this one, I will try to find out the average intensity of G1, that is M1, and G2, M2. And after this one, M1 plus M2 by 2. After doing that one, I will get the new threshold value. And after, again, I am getting the new threshold value as 128. Then again, I will repeat the same process until I am getting the two threshold values. Difference should be very negligible. So after segmented result using global threshold, so this is your, if I apply that particular segmentation on this particular thing, then I am getting the good result. Because in case of this segmentation, global thresholding, if it is greater than threshold, I will consider it as 1. If it is less than threshold value, then I will consider it as 0. So that whichever, only I will get the binary image, because whichever is having greater than threshold value, I will give 1 value, means white color, and whichever is having less than or equal to threshold value, then I will give it as 0. So that I will get only binary image. So after applying this principle of thresholding, I will get this, this is the final image. So this is your thresholding. And next one is histogram on thresholding. This just now we have discussed. There is always we will try to apply this histogram to find out the threshold value. If that, in case of the single level thresholding, we will have only one threshold value. After after drawing this particular histogram, we will have only one single threshold value. If it is greater than threshold value, then I can consider it as object. Otherwise, it is considered as background. And in case of this multi-level thresholding, if more than one objects, if you want to find out more than one object from the specific image, then I will have multiple thresholds. So that I have the histogram of that particular thing. So that this will be T1 and this will be T2. This is one value and this is another value. So value, so that I will take two thresholds. So here I have three things. One is the background. For background, one thing, one condition will be there for background, and for object one, I will have one condition, and object two, I have another condition. So T1 is less than or equal to that particular T2. If that particular intensity value is less than T1 and T2, then I can say it is the first object. And if it is greater than threshold, I can say it is the second object. If it is less than T1, I can say it is a background of the particular image. So this is multi-level thresholding. And in case of this multiple thresholding, multi-level means I have only two types of threshold, but if it is multiple thresholding, I can have more than one values. Like if Fi is the input image and T1, T2, T3 are the multiple threshold values. If I have whenever there are more number of objects in that particular image, like more than 3-4 images, I just want to segment that particular from that particular image, then I have to use this multiple thresholding, in which if that particular threshold is less than or equal to T1, then I can say it is the background. It is the background. And if it is less than or equal to T2, then I can say it is the object one. This is object one, and like this object two. And if it is less than, the maximum value is 255. So I can, how many objects are there in that particular image, based on that particular objects only, I will try to find out the different threshold values. That is called multiple thresholding. And next, adaptive thresholding. So which is nothing but dynamic thresholding, which is also discussed as dynamic thresholding. In case of this adaptive thresholding, we have discussed like it is mostly depending upon the XY coordinates. So adaptive thresholding changes the threshold dynamically over the image. So in case of this adaptive thresholding, we are not fixed with one threshold value. It is always changed. So that's why this is called dynamic thresholding algorithm. We are not, in case of the global thresholding, or it may be multiple thresholding, or it may be multi-level thresholding, or single level thresholding, we are fixed with one threshold value only. In case of single level, I will fix it with only one threshold value. If I have two threshold, if I have multi, that is bi-level, then I can say multi-level, then I can say two threshold values. If it is multiple, then I can say many number of threshold values may be there, but all are fixed. But if that particular threshold value will be changing dynamically over the image, like entire image, I will divide into that particular parts. I will divide into different parts. For this particular, I may consider that as 3x3 part or 5x5, anything. I will consider that particular part. And after this one, after applying this one, for this particular region, I will take one threshold value, that is T1. And for the second, I will take another value. That will be changing dynamically. Then I can say it is a dynamic thresholding algorithm. So adaptive thresholding works well in situation where image is affected by the non-uniform illumination problem. So what is this one is nothing but if the illumination, because most of the cases those images will not be having the proper lighting. Some images may be having good lighting, some may be not having lighting. So in case of those kind of images, we will try to use this adaptive thresholding, because one image may be having more lighting so that I can easily segment that particular image. And some image portions are not having the less lighting so that I can take another threshold value. But in case of if I am taking the single threshold value, then I cannot recognize that particular segment, or I cannot segment that particular image efficiently. So whenever there are non-uniform illumination, like the lighting is not distributed uniformly to the entire image, those kind of images, I will try to apply this adaptive thresholding. So what is this techniques to apply this thresholding algorithm is, divide the image into many overlapping sub-images. After dividing those image into many overlapping sub-images, overlappings may be there. Based on that one only, I will try to apply the thresholding for each image. And split the image into many sub-regions. So I can divide the image into many overlapping sub-images, or splitting the image into multiple sub-regions. So based on that one, I will try to apply this adaptive thresholding. Like if I take this adaptive thresholding, if I am taking considering this Sudoku image, here I am having some good lighting and here I am not having very good lighting. Here also some kinds are very bright and some kinds are not having that much of bright. So for these kind of images, I will try to apply this adaptive threshold. So in global thresholding, I have only one threshold value which is applied to the whole image. It may not be good in all the conditions where image has different lighting conditions in different areas. In that case, I will try to apply this adaptive thresholding, which is works better. So adaptive thresholding determines the threshold for a pixel based on the small region around it. So for this particular image, I will consider only this particular region, and I will consider this region, I will consider this region. For this region, I will try to have different threshold values for the different regions of the same image. So gives better results of the images with varying illumination. So I will take for this particular part, I will consider one threshold value. For this part, I will consider another threshold value, which is nothing but adaptive thresholding or dynamic thresholding. It is adaptive. I can it is adapting to the situation. So that's why it is adaptive thresholding or dynamic thresholding. And the last topic for this unit is this optimal Otsu thresholding algorithm, which is also used to find out the threshold value for the particular image. So to segment that particular image, what is the threshold value? For finding out that particular threshold, I will try to use this optimal Otsu thresholding algorithm. In case of this optimal thresholding, is used where there is a considerable overlapping of the histogram. So whenever there is a situation like I cannot find out, I cannot find out that particular threshold value in which there is a overlapping within the histograms, then I will try to apply this Otsu optimal thresholding algorithm. It uses the merit function of either maximization or minimization to determine the optimal threshold value. How to find out this optimal threshold value? Here, it will try to use this between class variance and within class variance to find out the optimal threshold value. So So this is Otsu's method of algorithm. It searches for the threshold intensity. This is the final intensity value, which maximizes the between class variance. So what is this between class variance? How to find out? We will see with the example problem. So here, what is the entire image? First, I will take particular image will be there. On that particular image, if I am taking this image, all these are like, this is the background of that particular image, which is in black, and all the kinds are the foreground. And I have multiple objects. So I have to take multiple thresholds over here. But if I consider this image, this entire thing is background, I will consider. Only this particular image, I will consider it as foreground. So I have only two parts. A single threshold value is enough. Here also, I will take this this entire thing as background, and this will be only this Sudoku puzzle, I will take it as foreground image. So based on that particular image, first what I will do is, first searches for the first whatever the image is there, in that image I will try to find out this WB values and mu B values. What is this WB? Is nothing but this is nothing but what is the number, we have the formulas for this one. So this is WB. WBWF, B is nothing but background of that particular image, and F is nothing but foreground of the image, and mu B is nothing but this is the mean values is mu, and the sigma is nothing but variance. So I will try to find out this between class variance of that particular image. So after finding out this between class variance, which is having this maximum between class variance, that will be considered as the intensity values. So I will take with one example. So here, what is the final motto is to find out this formula. Based on this formula, I will try to find out the between class variance. So after finding out this between class variance for all the different values, I will take whichever is giving the maximum between class variance, that will be considered as the threshold value. So how to find out? So what is the formulas for this one is WB. If you want to find out this WB is nothing but weighted sum. That is nothing but weighted sum of the variance. So weight. So W is nothing but weight part, and mu is nothing but that is your mean values. So here W is nothing but weight. We are having these two parameters for every image. I will have two parts only. Here I am considering only the image is having only two parts. One is the background image, another is the foreground image. If I take that particular thing, so for this every background part, I will try to find out the weights, and foreground part, I will try to find out the weights, and I will try to find out the mean values for the background part and mean values for the foreground part. And after this one, I will substitute those values over here. So what is the formula for finding out the weights is total number of pixels in the background or foreground. Right? If it is WB, then I can consider it as background. If it is F, I can consider it as foreground by total number of pixels. And mean value is nothing but mean intensity of the background. So if I'm taking one image like this, so this is the image, this entire thing is the background, and whichever is having this part, small lights, this is on white color, and this entire thing is the image, like we are having this particular image in this manner. I'm having this particular image on this. For example, if I'm considering, so for this one, I will try to represent the histogram. So I'm taking this as a simple example, because for the real time, I may have 500 by 500 rows, and each as having 0 to 255 intensity values. So here I'm taking just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 by 6, 6 by 6 image, which is having the intensity values only between some 0 to 5 only. So now this is the histogram of that particular image. So I will have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 0, 1, 2, 3, like this, I will 0 to 255 in this manner, in this direction, 0 to 255 in this direction. And after this one, 0, if I'm taking 0, how many zeros are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 9 zeros are there. So I will draw the histogram. I will mention it as 9 histogram, 9 zeros are there. So this in the real time also, for the image also in the same manner. After converting the particular image into the intensity values, all those intensity values will be between 0 to 255. So I will try to represent the histogram like here 0, 1, like this 255, and here also 0. How many 0 pixels are there? If it is like 100 0 pixels are there, then 100 I will have. 1, how many? Like this, I will try to draw the histogram. So same thing, here 0 are 9, and 1 are how many ones are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 ones are there. So I will write 2. How many 2s are there? 1, 2, 1, 2. Next 4 twos. Like this, I will try to draw the histogram. After drawing this particular histogram, I will assume I will take one intensity values. I will take one as here we are not in case of this Otsu algorithm. I will take one as the random value. That is nothing but I am considering here I value as 2. I will take it as I value as 2. So I value is 2. Which is nothing but I am taking this as the threshold value. I am taking this 2 as the threshold value. After this one, I am considering this as the foreground, which is having greater than 2, I will consider it as foreground, and which is having less than t, I will consider it as background. So for this one, yeah, this is the background. So background in the for easy understanding, I am representing this in the orange color. So this is your background. I am considering the t value as t 2 threshold value, which is having less than t. Less than t, whichever having this less than t, that is your background. That is nothing but background. This is your background, which is having less than t, and which is having greater than or equal to t, then those I will consider it as foreground. After considering this one, I will try to find out the weight values. So what is the formula for weight value? That is nothing but WB is nothing but total number of pixels in the background or foreground by total number of pixels. So if I am taking this WB background, total number of pixels in the background. So only on the background, I have 9 plus 6. Only I have number of pixels in the background is nothing but 9 plus 6. I'm having only in the background, I have 9. And for 0, I have 9. And for 1, I have 6. So 9 plus 6 by total number of pixels, how many I am having? I have 6x6, right? 6x6 total pixels are 36. So total number of pixels is 36. Like this, I will find out the WP value, that is nothing but background weight. And after this one, I will try to find out the mean value of this particular background. Mean value, what is the formula for this background mean value is, zero intensity values, with zero intensity values, 9 pixels are there. So 9 into 0 plus with 1 intensity values, I have 6 pixels. So 6 into 1 by total number of pixels that are there in that particular background only. That is nothing but 9 plus 6. So I have 9 plus 6. So this is the formula for finding out the mean value. So that is nothing but 9 pixels are there with 0 intensity value, 9 into 0. And 6 pixels are there with 1 intensity value. So 6 into 1 by total number of pixels in the background. So that is nothing but 9 plus 6. In the same manner, for foreground also, I will try to find out the weight value and mu value. That is nothing but WF weight value. That is nothing but, yeah, I have 4 pixels. Here I have 5. Here I have 8. And here I have 6. So 4 plus 5 plus 8 plus, 8 plus 4 by total number of pixels, 36. So this is your 0.48 you are getting for the weight. And in the same manner, I will try to find out the mean value for the foreground. That is nothing but 2 into 4 plus 3 into 5 plus 4 into 8 plus 5 into 4. So I will try to find out. And after this one, by total number of pixels in that particular thing. So that is nothing but here 4 are there, here 5 are there, here 8 are there, here 4 are there. So after doing that one, I will get 3.57. And what is the formula that is there in the Otsu algorithm is, that is nothing but I will try to find out the between class variance. So what is the formula for this between class variance is WB into WF into mu B minus mu F whole square. So I will try to substitute these values in this particular formula. For this, I'm considering only T value as 2. So I'm getting some value like 2.44. That is nothing but sigma. This is the between class variance, 2.44. In the same manner, I will try to find out the, I will take this intensity value. This is the threshold value. I will take T as 0 and T threshold value as 1 and threshold value as 2 and threshold value is 3 and threshold value is 4, threshold value is 5. In this manner, I will try to find out the between class variance for all the threshold values. I will take all the threshold values. But in the real time, I won't take that. I will try after drawing the histogram, I will consider this particular, whichever having 2 or more in that particular range, I will take only those 3, 2 or more values. In those 3 or more values, whichever is having the maximum between class variance, that will be considered as the final threshold value. So for if I'm taking this T as 0, then I'm getting WB, background mu B value. Substitute in the same manner. First, if I'm considering this as 0 only, this threshold value is 0. That is nothing but less than 0 background and all is are foreground. Then I will try to find out this background B value, W weight value and this mu value for foreground W value and foreground mean value, and I will try to substitute in the between class variance formula. So if I am using T value 0, then I am getting the between class variance as 0, and 1 if I am considering it as 1 means less than 1 or background I will consider, and greater than or equal to 1 I will consider it as foreground. So if I apply in this formula, I am getting the between class variance as 1.69. here I am getting 2.44 and 2.56, 2.17, 0.49. So wherever I am getting the maximum between class variance, that I will consider it as the final threshold value. So I will consider the what is the final threshold value for this one is T equal to 3. So after getting that particular 3 value, 3, then whichever is greater than that particular 3, those will be the object. This will be considered as object. And whichever for that, I will give the value as 1. And whichever is less than or equal to that particular 3, I will consider it as background. And for this one, I will try to give it as 0. So after applying that particular thing, I am getting the final image only containing zeros and ones values, because the final threshold value I am getting is 3, because I am getting this value is 3. And whichever is having less than or less than 3, I will consider it as this as the background, which is having the 0 value. And whichever is having greater than that particular, greater than or equal to 3, this is your foreground. This is your foreground, which is having 1 value. So I'm after that one also, I'm getting this image as this one. This is the foreground image and this is the background image. So like this, I will apply this principle of thresholding to find out the to segment the particular image. So whatever the image, input image that we are taking, this is the input image. For this image, I will try to after applying that particular principle of thresholding, it will divide that particular image into two portions. One is the background portion, and this is the foreground portion, which is used to segment that particular image. So what is the OTSU algorithm? That is nothing but first we will load the image, and I will try to find out the histogram. After finding out the histogram, I will try to find out the calculate the probability of every level. That is nothing but I will try to find out this probability probability of that is nothing but that is nothing but IT. So whatever this threshold values, and after this one I will try to find out this weights and mu for all the values for each value. That is nothing but zero intensity, that may be mu zero, and I will try after having this initialize this W0 mu I in this manner. What is this I value? Is nothing but total intensity values. How many intensity values are there? And after, for every threshold value ranging from 1 to maximum intensity, update this W and mu I values and compute this sigma b square. So same thing for I equal to 0, I am finding out WB, μB, WF, μF, and sigma b square, that is between class variance. For I equal to 1, I am finding out all the values. And after this one, after that is this step. For every threshold value ranging from, because initially I will assume the threshold value is 0. Initially I will assume 3i equal to 1. Like this, for each threshold value, I will try to find out the weight for the background and mu for the background and weight for the foreground and mu for the foreground. And by using this sigma square formula, I will try to find out the between class variance. And whichever is having the maximum between class variance, the corresponding threshold value is the optimal threshold value. This is the final threshold value. I will show with the example. Yeah, is the screen is visible, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, so first I will read that particular image. This is Lenna image, which is a famous image in the image processing technology. So for reading that particular image, I'm using this imread function. I'm using this computer vision library, that is computer vision. So this show is used to just showing the image, and we have a formula for finding out the histogram of that particular image by using this plot. So we have this calculator histogram. By using the I will take this image, I will take this particular image, and I will try to find out the frequency of pixels in the range, because this always whatever the color image, it is a color image only, but that color image I am considering into grayscale image. So grayscale, because color image means I have to consider RGB channel, and which is having three. So most of the image processing techniques, I will try to first convert the image into the grayscale image. So for converting that grayscale image, I am using this zero, so which will convert into the grayscale image. So grayscale image means 0 to 255 values only. And after this one, I am finding out the histogram of that particular image. For this one, I am using the formula calculator, calculate histogram. And after this one, I am plotting that particular histogram. So I will try to execute this. So this is the Lenna image in the grayscale form. So grayscale form. And after this one, for this image, I am having the histogram. This is the histogram of this particular image. Like this image is having most of the ranges between 50 to some around something 70 more number of pixels are there, and here some more pixels in the range of 150 to 200. So here I am unable to find out, because here we are having different types of but mostly I will take this as one value and this is another value, another value. So like this I am having, if I am taking this one, this is two values, whichever having, this is one threshold value and this is another threshold value. But I don't know how to exactly which will correctly substitute this particular, which will categorize that particular image. I have to find out the threshold value. For this, finding out this particular threshold value, I'm using this OTSU threshold value. So I'm using this image, I'm reading that particular image again. And by using this OTSU threshold algorithm, I'm applying this particular thresholding algorithm. I will try to find out the threshold value. So I will execute this particular code. After applying this OTSU threshold, I will get the threshold value as 124. Final threshold value is 124. For this, how it will do? First, 0 it will be considered, less than will be background, and greater than will be foreground. For this 0 also, I will try to find out this WB and mu B values, and WF and mu F values, and sigma B square I will find out. And for 1, I will find out the sigma B square. For second, for third, 50, for all these values, I will try to find out the sigma B. That is nothing but between class variance values for each pixel, for each, because in the initial stage, I will try to consider each one as the intensity value only. And whichever is having the maximum between class variance, that is the final threshold value. So here, the by using this Otsu algorithm, I am getting the final threshold value as 124. So whichever is having greater than 124, that is considered foreground image, and which is having less than 124, that is considered as a background image. So after applying this particular thresholding, I am getting the final segmentation like this. Whichever is having greater than this particular 124, that is with one value, and whichever is having less than 0, that is with zero, that is considered as background image. That's all, ma'am. That's it, ma'am. Thank you. Yeah. Yeah. That's it, ma'am. Thank you. This completes my total, third chapter.
Okay, Suresh, your contribution is very good. So you have worked a lot.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
You have started the research as per my knowledge.
Okay.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
You have really started your research work.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Good. Good. Very good.
Okay.
Okay. So from the next, when we have the next class? Next Monday?
Yes, ma'am.